Hi everyone, my name is Cathy Harley and I'm a program manager on the team at Microsoft that builds Planner and Project. Over the last year and a half, we've heard from many of our customers and personally experienced many of the benefits and challenges around managing work in a remote and hybrid world. Recently, the Microsoft Work Trend Index uncovered some figures related to remote and hybrid work. The study found that 73% of workers surveyed want flexible remote work options to continue. Remote job postings on LinkedIn increased more than 5 times during the pandemic. And over 40% of the global workforce is considering leaving their employer this year, and 46% are planning to move now that they can work remotely. Companies need to offer hybrid, remote, flexible work to retain and attract talent. Today, I'm going to talk about how our products are evolving to help any type of hybrid team plan, track, and collaborate on work that needs to get done. Let's get started with an introduction to our apps. Planner is based around an interactive Kanban board where teams can work together to create, track, and organize tasks. It's available on the web and integrated with Teams apps, so it meets you where you're already working. Here, we're working in Teams. One of the biggest challenges hybrid teams face is a lack of transparency around who is doing what. Conversations that used to happen after meetings and during lunch can get lost in a world of virtual meetings and chats. As you can see, this planner board is already pinned to the channel in Teams, where my team is collaborating, posting updates, and sharing files. In addition to this, Planner makes it easy to capture and organize tasks directly from my workflows, even as they come up in conversations. If I switch over to my chats, you can see that I have a thread here with two of my colleagues, Adele and Nancy, where something came up that I'm going to have to tackle. Instead of this getting lost, I can quickly get organized and add this task directly to my team's planner board. I can choose to see more options for this chat thread and select Create a Task. Now, once I'm here, I can choose the plan that I want this task to show up in. Here it's going to be my weekly team sync. I can update details I care about, in this case, the progress and the due date. And then I can add this task directly to my plan. Now, as you and your team continue to add and complete work to and from your plans, it can help to have a high level visual of what's going on. Planner has built-in charts to help you get a quick pulse on things. Let's check them out. We'll go back to our plan. So go back to the same one we looked at before. And I'm gonna go click on the charts tab. In here, in addition to seeing a summary of all of the tasks I have in my plan, I also get a visual of what's happening across all of my work, including what's assigned to my teammates and how status is trending. When your work starts to grow in complexity and costs, timelines, customization, and insights really start to matter, it's time for your team to move over to Project. We've given Project the same simple user experience as Planner that's integrated directly into Teams. This makes it easy for you to transition from one to the other. Here you see a simple grid view that's familiar to Planner and a board view. But what really differentiates Project is when I can track my tasks in a timeline view. With people working in different places and time zones, it can be hard to stay on top of how day-to-day changes impact your schedule and your bottom line. In timeline view, I can update the duration of tasks or the start date and the end date, even dependencies, simply by dragging and dropping. Here I can interact directly with my task and in a really visual way, see how changes happening on my team impact the overall plan. Now, Project also allows you to customize your tasks to store additional information. Let's go back to grid view for a second. Here you can see that I have a bunch of columns by default, but I can scroll over and add an additional column. Here, I'm going to choose to select a new field. And once I'm in this new field, I have a bunch of choices for the type of information that I'd want to track across all of my tasks. Once I go and create a field here, let's say whether or not a task has been reviewed, it'll automatically get created and added to all of my tasks. So I can update it for every single thing in my project in a customized way. Now, we know that people are often responsible for more than one project. There's leaders that need to keep track of all of the work happening across their organization. Project is built on the Microsoft Power Platform and comes with Power BI templates and integrations into Power Apps. These allow you to extract, customize, and publish insights into any and all of the projects across your organization. Here, using Project inside of Power Apps with the Project Accelerator installed, I see a summary of insights for all of my team's work. What I can also do, though, from this same surface is drill into the details so I understand at a detailed level why trends are happening at a high level. Went to projects and I see the same list of projects that I worked with in Teams. I can go and drill into tasks. And I can actually go and get a view of my project in the same place that's exactly the same as the one that I was working with earlier in Teams. And I can view and edit and make changes right here. Now let's talk about what's coming for both Project and Planner over the next year. Our plan is to simplify and bring the experiences of Planner and Project closer together so that moving from one to the other is effortless. We're also going to continue to add new functionality to make managing work a lot easier and less time consuming. On the Planner side, we recently added support for moving tasks to other plans and, as you saw in the demo, creating tasks from Teams messages. You can also now see intelligent suggested attachments in your tasks that help you save time hunting through all of your folders to find the right work to attach to your tasks. We'll soon add support for reoccurring tasks and, as part of our Microsoft Loop solution, for syncing tasks created in team meetings back to Planner. These investments prioritize simplifying the user flow across Microsoft 365. We envision eventually integrating these investments into the project experience as well. On the project side, we've recently enabled support to customize and extend project further through flexible deployment, where you can deploy project to different environments based on your organization's needs. We also launched APIs for creating, updating, and deleting projects and tasks. Soon, project tasks will flow into the Assign to You list in the Teams Tasks app and the To-Do app alongside Planner tasks that already appear there, so there's a single place to manage all of the tasks assigned to you from across Microsoft 365. We're also bringing more Planner features to Project to make the transition between apps simpler, including support for guest users, the ability to add checklists to tasks, task labels, and out-of-box charts. I hope that you're excited about the updates landing in Project and Planner to make it easy for you and your hybrid team to manage projects and work. I'd love for you to give them a try and let us know what they think. If you're a project subscriber, you can get started at project.microsoft.com. And if you're a Microsoft 365 subscriber, you can use Planner by visiting tasks.office.com. We'd also love to hear your feedback and feature requests for how we can continue to improve Planner and Project. You can reach us by finding the Give Feedback option on the bottom left of the Help control in your navigation bar in Teams when you're working in a project or a plan that's pinned to a channel. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this session helpful.